Just when you thought Samuel L. Jackson couldn't get more intimidating. Meeting Evil, an independent film that went straight to DVD, written for the screen and directed by Chris Fisher, starring Luke Wilson, Samuel L. Jackson, and Leslie Bibb. The story follows a real estate agent who hasn't sold a house in a long time and his bills are stacking up. He has a nice house, beautiful wife, and two kids. But on this particular day in his life when he hasn't sold this one house and he's very upset, down on his luck, Sam Jackson comes knocking on his door, and that's not a good sign. And his day slowly spirals out of control. Goes from bad to worse, just plain WTF status. It starts out in the beginning very clearly a drama, and then at the end it becomes more of a thriller. It reminded me a lot of that movie Lakeview Terrace, which Jackson was also in. This movie was okay. Right off the bat, I will say that Samuel L. Jackson is the best part of this movie. In fact, he pretty much steals the whole goddamn thing. But oddly enough, he's not really playing a character. He's playing a guy who acts irrational and people really piss him off, or when people piss other people off that he likes, and he really has no clear objective. The script tries to give him an identity at the very end, but it feels very forced and unrealistic. The script also forces something onto Leslie Bibb's character, which makes absolutely no sense at all. Throughout the entire film, she's accused of two things. Only one of them makes sense based on what little we know about her. And she doesn't get a ton of screen time, so there's really no development of her character. There's also a woman brought in about midway in the film who knows Luke Wilson's character. She adds nothing at all to the story. If her character had been scratched from the script and she was never mentioned at all, this movie would be better. Probably the most upsetting part of this film is how, when it ends, we leave the family where they were in the beginning. Nothing's changed. A guy came into their life and stirred the pot, but at the end, what remained in the pot is the same. Certain things have been revealed, yes, but they don't change anything. So while I did enjoy the first half, I can't really recommend it. It was directed and edited very well, I will say that. And it looked nice, photography-wise. Every location had its own look. So I'm gonna give it 2.5 out of 5 stars. I think if you're a diehard Jackson fan, then you'll enjoy it more than somebody simply looking to kill time. Thanks as always for watching, guys. Hopefully I will see you tomorrow.